Why is your domain name not selling? Why is your domain name not selling? Hey, Chris Sack with Media Options, help companies acquire the raw, unfiltered version of the brand name through domain acquisitions. It'll broker in some of the best domains on the planet. So check it out, mediaoptions.com. Check out chriszuiker.com, my podcast I do daily with a lot of good stories, usually about 5 to 7 minutes. And then YouTube channel, I have some more information there, and make sure we're connected on LinkedIn. But okay, listen. Why is your domain name not selling? Ah, this is a deep, deep conversation. So there's number one, it's just not worth anything. No one wants it. Consider that possibility that your domain name is just not worth anything. Okay, let's assume you have a good domain, though. Let's assume your domain has some value. So why is it not selling? Why is it not selling? Why aren't these companies that could buy your domain, that could create a marketing campaign around it, why are they not coming and buying it? Okay, the first thing is visibility. Visibility. They gotta know it's available. So if they don't know it's available, they don't know it's an option. Well, then hey, they're not gonna buy it, right? So that's why different platforms are good. That's why companies will come to Media Options, because we just have eyeballs. Okay, so we have 5,000 people a day that are watching that are coming to our site, maybe like 50 to 120 people that are actually on the site at any given time. And so that's visibility. It's visibility. We do outbound brokerage to decision makers. I do it personally. I have over 100,000 contacts selling domain names. Do they know it's even available? You could have some good domain names, but if you're not putting them on a platform, not going to sell. Okay. There's other platforms out there. Sato, there's GoDaddy, you pick it. You can pick your platform. FD, I like FD. I think I've seen some good sites there that kind of combine all the different domains. But visibility. Then there is valuation. Make sure the price is right. And then there is viability. Is the company the right company? The right company. So you can have a good domain and you get it to a Fortune 500 company, but they're like, listen, just we don't need it. Okay, we don't need it now. I'm going to go a different route here, okay? So I could go down that route. I could talk about the who you contact, but I want to go to this route. Assuming that you have a domain name, you have people that you've reached out to, and yet they're not buying it. Like, you've got it in front of them. The reason they're not buying is they're just not a pain. Not a pain. Most successful companies, guess what? They are already making a profit. If they weren't making a profit, they could not afford your domain name, okay? Unless they had venture funding, whatever, okay? But there's a thought to make a profit there, and most are launching on something. So they're making a profit. Why would they buy your domain? Why would they spend $6 figures to $1 million on your domain name? Let's say 5 figures on your domain name. Pain. There's the pleasure. There's all the reasons why you need to own that domain name. There's global positioning. There's leadership positioning. SEO, branding, marketing, email security, the ability to scale and pivot. What happens is that most domainers, they start off with this line like, hey, this is premium real estate. Your customers are going to remember this domain. This is awesome. This is a great domain. Look at the search. All good stuff. Not the right timing. See, there's this pull between pain and pleasure, between pain and pleasure, and opening up this gap that's in there. Okay, I'm paraphrasing Garrett White here. If you haven't seen him, check him out. He's doing a conference coming up here. I recommend it to anyone. But is the pain and the pleasure. There's not enough pain that they experience, that their ability to scale will be forever at risk because another brand, another company is going to come in and acquire their domain name. Their ability to own the global positioning is at risk because another company with stronger funding is going to come in and acquire their domain name. their emails, their sensitive emails being read by another company because they created confusion with their domain name. And by the way, we've got your emails. I'm forwarding them to you. Pain. You see, but it's not, you can't just like go after them, okay? Because I see a lot of blog posts out there that are just like, screw you, you want this, it's $300,000. Okay, that's just rudeness, okay? That's just like a, you're trying to get that very, very small percentage of the population, very, very small percentage of companies that are going to say, okay, I want this domain name so bad, I'm willing to pay you for above and beyond the value. Okay, so I talk about what the value of a domain name, there's raw equity in the keyword, there's brand equity, and there's perceived equity. And that perceived equity is many times what those type of, why those type of deals sell for such a very, very big price. I'm not talking about that. I'm not talking about being rude. I'm talking about there's this flow that comes to bringing out the pain and showing them the pain, showing them that their ability to scale is impacted. Now, you can't just do that most times over one email. It just doesn't happen because of just how it works, right? It's like you have maybe a sentence, maybe you have a couple of paragraphs that they're going to read, and it takes time for it to marinate, time for it to soak in, time for them to think about it. What typically happens is that they get this message, they go in to a meeting, they think, it's just not going to work, we don't need it. And they go to this meeting and they bring it up, their company says, okay, we're going to pass. Then it comes time they're having problems scaling. Then it comes time their marketing is not effective. Then it comes time they say, well, hold on a second, like what's happening? Could this be our domain name? Or their investors come back to them and say, listen, are you guys crazy? Like your domain name is out there. I've seen it. Like I've seen that it's out there. It's available for sale. Why don't you own it? This changes their worldview. The worldview before says, hey, I'm doing fine without it. And their worldview instantly changes overnight. So I have to have that domain name. There's also a journey that companies go through, a journey that startups go through, a journey that founders go through, where they initially start, they say, oh, you know what, listen, I'm okay with there being multiple brands. I'm okay with that because right now I'm in hustle mode. But at some point, when they go into CEO and marketer mode, they say, it's not okay. Like only one person can hold that brand. So I'm digressing. That's a completely different frame, completely different conversation on this journey for domain names. But today I'm talking about this is like, consider the possibility that your domain name is not selling because there's no pain involved with that person not owning your domain name. It's pleasure. It's opportunity. Now there comes a time when opportunity, yes, they say, okay, we've got this money, we want to invest it and we need this. Okay. But kind of still comes back to pain. Okay. So we don't have this. It's not going to work as effectively. So we need to own this marketing campaign domain name, this new brand domain name, because we need to own the messaging and all the seven dimensions for how a domain name impacts a brand. But once again, I just want to caution you, okay, I'm giving you some good advice here, the domain community, some good advice on why your domain name is not going to sell, but you have to do this the right way. So often I see owners try to do this, and it just does not come across the right way. If you own your domain name and you're trying to communicate this message, trying to give this pain messages, it just comes across so much differently than, say, when they hear it from a broker like Media Options, they hear it from Drew or hear it from me. Because we're out there communicating this every single day. They can see it. They can see it on my Facebook. They can see it on my YouTube. They can see it on my LinkedIn. They can see it on my site. They can see it on Media Options site. They can see it on Domain Sherpa. They expect us to push them. They expect us to show them the pain. That's our job. My job is to get it across the finish line. My job is to get you to see a different worldview when I come in. When I first reach out to most people, like they're not even thinking about domain names. It's the farthest thing on their mind. You got to break through that. You got to get through the noise to show them that, hey, this is the biggest risk that you possibly have to your brand. The biggest risk you possibly have to your scaling, the biggest risk you have to your email security. So what brought this topic up? What brought this subject up? I just got an email from a company that I am negotiating with, and they said, hey, we're going to launch our activities on a .me domain. Now, this is a big company. They've raised a lot of money. In fact, let me see how much they've raised. I think they've raised like $300 million. Let's see here. Looks like over 25 million, but there's a couple of different versions of this company. So they've raised a lot of money. So let's just say for the sake of this, 25 million. And they're going to launch on .me because they don't want to pay the difference between the delta, between where we're at, where the price of this domain's at, and what they have in their budget, this mythical number that they've created in their mind that this is all they want to spend on this domain name. Now, have they looked at the true return on investment? No, they haven't. Have they looked at the true impact to their brand? No, they haven't. There's another major brand that's launching on the same keyword that we started negotiations with. And the thing is this, is that if this other brand acquires it, they're going to pump money into their marketing. That money is going to then drown out the messaging for this other company. It's then going to make this other company look silly. It's going to make this other company look like a dead brand because people are going to come and say, well, how do you not, you're a tech company. How do you not own your brand? How did you let this other company acquire it? Now, what inevitably happens is that they just get drowned out. They get pushed out. And the other company takes the leadership position. This is what happened with Kraken Crypto Exchange and Crap and Rum. Now, crypto exchange market has taken a big dip, a big beating, but inevitably Kraken Rum, it's not even out there. The message is not out there, and yet they spent millions of dollars more in advertising. So that's what triggered me this morning to say for this conversation. And really, I've helped to get them into the pain, showing them, hey, listen, like this is, you don't understand the risk that you have. When you look at this over 5 to 10 years, where the delta that we're at is nothing, nothing truly over 5 to 10 years. But if you look at this over 5 to 10 years, if another company acquires it, it's everything to your brand. Like this will be the pivotal moment. Your company, your investor, your leadership team will look back and say, that was it. It was that decision that we made, that we did not make, that we decided to pass on this domain name, that inevitably led up to another brand rising up, another brand drowning out our messaging, our positioning. They inevitably hurt our marketing because every time we market now, there's this halo effect, another brand. Completely changed our metrics. Completely changed our profitability model. Because you passed on owning your brand. This is big. Okay, that's it. That's all I'm sharing today. Hope you got something out of it. A little bit long this video, but very important to understand this dynamic. And listen, don't do this the wrong way. If you're a domain investor, you have to approach this the right way. If you approach it the wrong way, it comes across as very rude. And inevitably what can happen is that you could potentially kill the deal. Okay, you can kill the deal. So there's a right way to do it. There's a wrong way to do it. Keep watching my videos. I'm going to go into more and more detail on this as I do these live videos, as I do more videos and upload this, so there's more information coming. But hey, if you liked it, share this up, okay? Because you're not paying me to do this. I'm doing this out of my desire and my passion for domain names. So make sure you share this video up. And if you found value in this.